Today on BRStv, we have our 17th episode of the Neptune Apex series, Alarms. Hi, I'm Ryan, host of BRStv, where each week we cover a new topic related to reefing. This week, we're going to show you how to use the Apex alarms and configure them using Apex Fusion cloud-based interface. There are three different types of alarms, and they're all what's referred to as a virtual outlet, which means they're programmed the same way you would program an outlet. It's easiest to think about it as a real outlet that has an alarm plugged into it and goes off based off the statements that you enter. The three outlets are labeled as abbreviations of sound warning, sound alarm, and email alarm. Basically, the warning is just an infrequent beep designed to make you aware of a situation, like maybe the pH is slightly higher than you would like it. Sound alarm is an alarm that goes off constantly to tell you something's really wrong with the tank. An email alarm is, as you might guess, a list of events you want to be notified via email or text message should they ever happen. I suggest testing all three based on an easy alarm like temp and see what each does for yourself. You can check out what each sounds like by sliding the alarm status bar from auto to on. Once you're done, slide it back to off and then back to auto. The email and SMS text message component used to be difficult to set up previously, but with Apex Fusion, all you need to do is hit settings under your username, click the notification tab, and then add a recipient. Select email or text and add your email address or phone number, and it's completely set up. Really super simple. Setting up the alarms is a bit harder because you need to write the command lines. Hopefully they'll add one of the nice configuration tools for this in Fusion soon, but we'll show you some of the more common command lines with the assumption that you're using the default probe names. The first line should always be set off, which will make sure the alarm is off by default. Note that proper spacing and capitalization is important. First alarm is typically related to temperature and something like if temp greater than 82 then on, if temp less than 75 then on. We'll set off alarm if the temp ever goes over 82 or below 75. Then something pretty similar with pH. If pH greater than 8.5 then on, if pH less than 7.7 then on. Which will turn on the alarm if the pH ever gets over 8.5 or below 7.7, both of which are a pretty good indicator that something's wrong with the tank. Alarms based on ORP are also popular. If ORP less than 250 then on, if ORP greater than 450 then on. The low will likely be triggered by something large dying in the tank or a large release of organics like a bag of food spilled into the tank, which you'd want to deal with immediately. High is likely ozone-related equipment failure. You can also set off an alarm based off a switch level like a float switch with a line like if switch 6 closed then on. The same thing can be used on a door switch to set off an alarm if the door is opened, which can help keep kids out. If switch 7 open, then on. The ALD leak detector switches should have alarms to help save your home from damage. In this case, we would add a line that looks like switch X5_1 closed, then on. Note that the X on the switch is what indicates this is an ALD leak sensor rather than a simple switch. Your module name will likely be different depending on the sensor used and module number the Apex assigned your ALD module. Another good one is based on the conductivity or salinity module. If Condex 4 less than 33, then on. If Condex 4 greater than 37, then on. Which will set off the alarm if the salinity ever drops or rises suddenly. Note that your code might look different. The number after the X signifies the module number, and the alarm points will depend on what you're measuring salinity in, parts per thousand or conductivity. Remember to test each alarm when you add it to make sure it's working properly. If you're having issues, one of the common causes is the name of the probe is different, so make sure to check the names of the probes in the setup area of the display or on the tiles within the Fusion interface. So I know some of you still have questions or have great ideas for alarm code you've used and want to share it with the rest of us. So do it in the comments area down below. If this is your first time with us, subscribe because we do this every week. See you next week with another episode of BRStv.